Good evening, and a very warm welcome to everyone watching this live stream concert from the McPherson Recital Room in the Laidlaw Music Centre here at the University of St Andrews. This is an incredibly exciting evening in a number of ways, not least because this is the very first choral concert that has been given in this wonderful space. When we were planning the acoustics and the design of this room with our architect Jason Flanagan and our acoustician Nicholas Edwards, one of the things we were most concerned to achieve was a space particularly attuned to choral singing, given the excellence of the many choral groups who work and sing at the university. And from the 30 seconds I've heard so far, I think we've succeeded in that, and I'm sure you'll agree. And we look forward to many, many more choral concerts, which you can attend in person in the future. This concert is a three-way joint promotion by the St Andrews Music Club, the long-established town music club, and the St Andrews University Music Centre, who of course collaborate together already on a well-established concert series, which we hope very much will be returning in person in the autumn. And the third, but by no means the least important member of the collaborating group that has made tonight possible, is St Andrews Voices, Scotland's festival of the voice, from whose artistic director, Amanda MacLeod, you'll be hearing later in this streaming. We're thrilled and privileged that this first choral concert is being given by Voces 8, one of the world's leading a cappella choral groups. During their short visit to St Andrews, they have worked extremely hard, as well as the concert you're about to hear. They have worked with members of the university's many a cappella groups. They've worked with school-aged children who have submitted compositions to a workshop with them. And they've worked with the St Andrews Voices innovative Singing for Lung Health group. So we're very grateful to them for all they've packed into their visit. And you know, we hope they'll be able to come for longer and meet people in person in the future. This is also the launch of a new means by which you, anyone watching, can support what I hope you will agree has been an exciting series of live stream concerts to keep us all going through the lockdown. In fact, I hope it's more than that, because through the lockdown, we've realised that people have watched our concerts from all over the world, particularly members of the alumni community of St Andrews. And so even when we're able to welcome people back into the room, we intend to carry on live streaming most, if not all, of the concerts we present from this room, which is going to be a wonderful way for people all over the world to stay in touch with St Andrews. But of course, this doesn't come cheap. And so tonight we are launching a Saints Funder appeal, whereby you can help the costs of live streaming concerts in the future and enable us to do it better and better. It's very simple to find out about this scheme. You can either scan the QR code that you'll see in your screen, or you can go to the web address that you'll find in the description for tonight's concert. And of course, my colleague Chris Bragg or I would be very happy indeed to tell you more about this appeal and what we plan to do with the funds we raise. Without further ado, I would like to welcome for this very exciting concert, Voces 8.
Oh, Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. A very warm welcome from myself and my colleagues in Votches 8. That feels a little bit like the walk of shame, almost like I've been voted off the game show as the first contestant to leave. But unfortunately for you, I'll be making my way back in just a minute. We are thrilled to be here in St Andrews. The group was last here in 2015. Of course, not just for the music, but also for the golf. Being an avid golfing fan, you'll be pleased to know I took my run this morning around the old course. We're going to sing you a programme which has many different types of music in it this evening. And we've started there in the English Renaissance with arguably the most famous composer of his generation, William Byrd, and his wonderful anthem, Sing Joyfully. We're going to stay in the English Renaissance for our next piece to hear from Byrd's teacher, Thomas Tallis. And we're going to sing you a hymn which Tallis wrote for the Feast of the Transfiguration, when Jesus appeared ablaze on top of the mount with the prophets. Tallis depicts this imagery in his hymn by setting a stratospheric high soprano part, which will be sung by Andrea tonight. And it always maintains an interval of at least a sixth above the rest of the harmony underneath. Talking of the harmony, Tallis, well, you can always tell when you've heard a little bit of Tallis. There's something in his writing, a sort of signature, but it's difficult to put your finger on it. But I think in this case, it is the harmony. So listen out for some of those glorious false relations. At the beginning and end of the Tallis, we're going to insert just a little bit of chant that we have made up ourselves, just to bring a little bit of drama to the scene and give a feeling of flow through the music. And that's going to flow into a modern composition. In fact, a composition that was commissioned by this festival for us in 2015. It was written by Philip Stopford, who is a great friend of Votches 8. He was an Abbey chorister, where I myself also was a boy. And now he lives and works over in the US in Brooklyn, and we're very much in touch with him and enjoy very much singing his work. So this is the Ave Maristella, and it works quite well with the Tallis that we're going to sing before it, because he really uses that idea of chant to weave in this contemporary feel to that genre. So we have O Nata Lux de Lumines by Thomas Tallis, followed by Ave Maristella by Philip Stopford.
think it's very easy to see why that piece, although it was only written a few years ago, is already a classic of the modern choral repertoire. We're going to sing you now two pieces that are also in that realm of classics of the repertoire. The first, by Mendelssohn, is from his oratorio Elijah. If you're in a choral society, you're sure to have sung it before. It's called Denn er hat seinen Engeln befohlen über dir, for he shall give his angels watch over thee. At this particular point in the plot, Elijah is in the desert, and God sends a flock of angels to watch over him. After that, a Russian treasure, this time by Sergei Rachmaninoff. It's a setting of the Ave Maria text, which in Church Slavonic becomes Bogolodice Dievo. We sing a lot of polyphonic music in Voces 8, and I think this piece perhaps makes the case for simple four-part harmony being perhaps the most beautiful music there is. So, two choral treasures from Mendelssohn and then Rachmaninoff.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone, and on behalf of St Andrew's Voices, just to reiterate Michael's words from earlier, it's really exciting to have this amazing group here in St Andrew's, and hopefully very, very soon you'll be able to join us in this amazing space as well. I hope the acoustics are coming across how well and exciting as it feels in the room just in front of these fab group of eight singers. Now, joining me over here is a dear friend of mine, Ewan and I think we have known each other for many, many years singing together in the National Youth Choir and then overlapping a bit with Genesis 16. Now, Ewan, coming back, have you performed with Foch's Eight in Scotland before? Is this the first time? And I guess, how does that feel?
This is very much the first time, yeah. I think actually, potentially, maybe before even Blake, my fellow tenor, was in the group, was the last time we were in Scotland. But so yeah, it's a real pleasure. I think it's a nice feeling coming home and getting to do this kind of thing that I really love.
We should also let you know that we do have an honorary tenor also in the tenor section. An honorary tenor? An honorary Scot in the tenor section.
I often call him an honorary tenor.
Yeah, okay, honorary tenor, who knows? Sorry, Blake, no offence. we're just about to introduce two pieces of Scottish music. One from late, let me get this right, 16th century and early 17th century. And then someone who's very well known to us in St Andrews. He is an honorary professor, so I wonder if you'd like to
Yeah, of course. I think, obviously, it's super important. We always try and bring something of the music of where we are performing to our concerts. So it's a real pleasure to do these two quite great choral gems, I think. First is Robert Ramsay's setting of the popular verse from the Bible, When David Heard. And then I think probably Scotland's most famous living composer, certainly, James McMillan, and his setting of a text that you've already heard in this concert, the Ave Maris Stella.
Brilliant. Thank you, Ewan.
Oh,
Now, lots of noise is happening behind us. We've spoken at length about this room and all it can do. The floor can come up. It can actually come up higher than that. It can also sink down. It's really quite exciting, all the possibilities that we will be able to make this room look different at future concerts. The curtains are coming down behind us. Barney, what was it like to sing in the space when the curtains were fully up?
Quite remarkable, actually. Almost like being in a church. There's actually a resonating chamber, isn't there, above the roof. And that means, just like the dome in a church, the sound goes up and resonates, and it's magnificent. Actually, there were a couple of moments earlier in the day when we were rehearsing, and the thought crossed my mind, gosh, that person sounds good on that today. And then I realised, well, maybe it's the room. Not, it's always good, I should say that. Always good. Even better.
So my colleagues do tell me that it's the smallest venue in the world with the sort of resonators that it has. That is pretty exciting for our little town in the northeast of Fife. So the curtains have now come down. How will you work with that differently for the next two pieces?
Well, essentially, it makes the space drier. You may already be able to hear that in my speaking voice, which, given the distance that we're singing at today, which is 2 metres, that's a challenge anyway, but actually with the drier space, it's a little bit more straightforward because there's less reverberation in the room, so everything has a bit more clarity. So we've chosen to bring it down as much as anything else to show off a little bit to you, but also because we will sing some madrigals in a minute, which have a lot of fast-moving polyphony in them, and it brings an extra clarity, which is brilliant for the repertoire.
So those madrigals...
Well, yes, they're coming in a minute. I dare not introduce them because Johnny does a great speech and I wouldn't like to steal his thunder. But before that, we're going to sing a couple of folk songs. I shouldn't really be introducing these to a Scottish audience. The first we sing, actually, because we were asked to present some Beethoven in 2020 at a festival in France. And there's not a lot of Beethoven for unaccompanied voices, as I'm sure you're aware. So we didn't think we'd arrange the Ninth Symphony or anything like that. Instead, we found his wonderful Scottish and Irish folk songs, and this is one of those arrangements by Joshua Pacey, Johnny's brother, called Loch Nagar, gives our Scottish boy Ewan a chance to sing another solo. And then we have O Waly Waly, which is actually an arrangement that we had in the group's repertoire probably as much as a decade ago, but it hasn't been sung so much recently, so it's very nice to bring back for the occasion. And that is a melody for Andrea, followed by Ewan. So a nice pairing.
Away ye dear lands, did see gardens of roses, As promised, we're going to journey back to the 17th century and sing you two madrigals now. The first is from England, and it's taken from a larger set of 25 madrigals called The Triumphs of Oriana that was compiled at the very beginning of the 17th century by Thomas Morley. This is As Vesta Was from Latmos Hill Descending by Thomas Wilkes. And in it, Vesta, the goddess, is coming down Latmos Hill with her nymphs. And Oriana, the queen, is coming up the hill with her shepherds. And when the nymphs and the shepherds meet in the middle, well, what they get up to, I'll have to leave to your imaginations. It also paints a glorious picture of the fair Oriana. Oriana was the literary nickname at the time for Queen Elizabeth I. After that, we're going to hop across the English Channel into northern France and sing Dessous le Marché d'Arras by Orlando di Lasso. This takes place in the marketplace of Arras, and there's lots of chattering going on, which you can hear painted in Lasso's music. A Spaniard arrives there in the marketplace and announces to a group of women that if one of them will accompany him home for the night, he can offer them plenty of money. A nice sort of family feeling one, this one. Now, we have to do a bit of stage management in between these two pieces, so if you're lucky enough to be in the room and you, behind the camera lens, would like to go wild in between the two pieces, please do feel free. So here we are, two 17th century madrigals from either side of the English Channel.
The presence of 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 the pres We had the pleasure of working with some young composers and we had a workshop with them where we kind of just discussed a few different ideas surrounding their compositions, both how they might take their process forward, but also talking about how we approach new music as an ensemble. One of those students, Harry Baines, wrote an arrangement of A Fond Kiss, Robert Burns' beautiful poem. And that shares some similarities with the last music in our programme this evening, in that they are also all arrangements of folk tunes. Firstly, we're going to sing for you one of our favourites, Underneath the Stars, which was written by Kate Rusby, who is a Yorkshire singer-songwriter. And this is an arrangement by our arranger in residence, Jim Clements. Following that, we're going to sing the famous Londonderry air to the words "O Danny Boy" in an arrangement also by Joshua Pacey, Johnny's brother, who you heard his arrangement of Loch Nagar just a moment ago. In case you'd like to know anything more about our education and outreach work, or indeed any of the performances we've got coming up in our diaries, you can stay in touch with us through our social media accounts on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram, and also on our website, voces8.com. But for now, here's two folk songs, Underneath the Stars and Danny Boy.
And there beneath the stars I'll lead you before.
piece. Just a huge thank you to everybody who's made this possible. As Michael said, this has been a three-way co-promotion between ourselves, St Andrew's Voices, and we'd really like to thank Lyle Design and Creative Scotland for their support for this concert. St Andrew's Music Club, with grateful support from the Chamber Music Scotland Transition Fund and also the Cookie Matheson Trust. And finally, the University of St Andrew's Music Centre and all their supporters who make this happen. Obviously, the QR code has been down here on your screen for throughout the whole performance, so hopefully you might be able to, everyone's used in the UK anyway, to scanning into NHS apps and things, so hopefully the scan has become a lot more familiar to you and you might be able to donate and support this performance and also future performances from this amazing space in St Andrews. Now, the final piece, looking at my watch, and I didn't think I'd get this in, but obviously the football has started, so we're fingers crossed that all goes Scotland's way tonight. That adopted tenor, that adopted Scot that I spoke about earlier, Blake, has arranged the most sublime version of Dougie MacLean's classic, Caledonia. So from everyone here in St Andrews, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you enjoy.